Can an INFJ be successful in business? Hi everybody! Today I am celebrating from having my best month in business. I had these goals for September and I completely smashed it. I doubled the income that I set for myself and I met all these other goals. It got me thinking, as an INFJ, can we really be super successful? I used to think that I couldn't be successful in business because of my personality type and because of who I am, but I am now in a place where I fully believe that INFJs can absolutely be amazing at business, and I believe that you as an INFJ can create a business that you are super proud of, that is bringing you an income, and you feel like your days are truly fulfilled and valued. I believe that if we can fully align ourselves with what our values are and lean into our strengths as an INFJ, then yes, we absolutely can be successful business people. We can be successful entrepreneurs. I'm in a lot of INFJ Facebook groups. There is one common theme that I see in all of these groups, and that is that a lot of INFJs, they see themselves as broken. They've been so used to feeling left out, a little bit different, rejected, perhaps not taken seriously, or just simply misunderstood, that they've begun to internalize all of that. So if you've grown up your whole life not feeling like you quite belong, or you talk in a different way, or you think in a different way, you can begin to internalize that. And if you're a wounded INFJ, which is what I see in a lot of these Facebook groups, then wounded INFJs generally have a negative self-belief and thoughts about themselves. I think that if you want to be successful in business and be a successful entrepreneur, the first step that you need to do is begin doing the personal development work. For me, it took a lot of work, a lot. I'm talking years and years and years of working on myself, working on my thought life, the way I think, the way I see the world, working on my self-worth, my values, but it's been so worth it. Once you have that unshakable belief within yourself, there is nothing that can stop you. I believe that INFJs are such a powerful personality type, but it just takes you getting to that place where you truly believe in yourself. You believe that you can succeed at whatever you put your mind to. If it aligns with who you are and aligns with your values and your beliefs, there will be nothing that can stop you. But it starts with that self-development work, which is why I am really passionate about being a counselor for INFJs and working with INFJs to begin to break down some of those negative self-beliefs and that wounded self and begin working on, you know, healing your inner child, doing that work, going back into your childhood and healing that and looking into your present and seeing how you think and feel and act and how that can all interrelate with each other. Because if you can work on that, you can absolutely be a successful business owner. The next step for an INFJ to be successful in business is to not compare your business journey to someone else's. And that is something that I really, really had to learn, and it took me a long time to learn this, because it's, let's face it, we are different. You are different. We are different people. We relate to the world in a completely different way, and that's perfectly okay. But you can't look at a more extroverted business leader and think that that's how you need to do business, because you need to stand on your uniqueness and you need to build your business on the way that you work as an INFJ. And that's why it's so important that you begin to learn what the strengths are of an INFJ. You can use your high value system, you can use your structured mindset, your empathy, your observation and listening skills to do things in a way that connects you with your customer or client. I believe that all of our strengths as INFJs, it's our superpower, and we need to embrace that and know that these little superpowers that we have as INFJs, it can absolutely mean that you can create the sort of life that you want to create for yourself. I really do believe that INFJs are best suited working for themselves and having their own business and being entrepreneurs, because you can create a schedule that works for you and works for your personality type. I think a 9-to-5 job or 9-to-5 hours can be a bit of a struggle for INFJs. I think going to work meetings where it's hard for you to actually share what your thoughts are on a situation can be really hard. It's hard working for others when you don't fully believe in what you are doing. Don't get me wrong, there is nothing wrong in being in employment, and I've been in I've worked for others for most of my life until more recently, but I've managed to stay in those roles for a long time because I did believe in the cause of the organizations I worked with. I was working with others. I worked in social services and youth work. So yes, those values aligned with mine. I know for me, I am someone that needs a lot of naps during the day, and you can't have naps when you're at work. When I do my best work, I need to step away from things and have that reflection time. I need time to connect with my intuitive self. When I was working for others, I found that really hard to do. I couldn't just tell my boss, I'm gonna go for a walk for an hour so that I can connect with my intuition so that I know what the next step is. Having my own business has allowed me to be in my own flow, in my own rhythm, in a way that best suits me and my needs. And the best thing is I completely believe and I'm passionate about what I do. And for an INFJ to be successful in business, you really need to connect with what your passion and beliefs are. Whether that's, you know, improving the environment, improving humanity, being in the arts or music or whatever it is, if it aligns with your values and your beliefs, then nothing can stop you because you'll go for it because that's what we're about. We're about improving humanity. When you are working towards something that you truly believe in and you truly value, it is so satisfying. It's so rewarding that at times you could be working really long hours and working hard, but it doesn't feel like work. It's enjoyable. It's fulfilling. It makes you feel good. And it's fun as well. I have a lot of fun in my business. And of course, I work around my family. I work around my kids. I'm at home with my kids more than I'm in my business. But when I'm working on my business, I get a lot done because I believe in what I'm doing. I love working with my clients. I love counseling. I love providing resources for you. And I am in the middle of creating different workbooks that for you guys to have to help build yourselves up. And I do have one available, which is my Building Assertiveness workbook, which you can grab. There's a link down in the bio for you to grab that. I just want to point out two online entrepreneurs that I know that are INFJs and are super successful in what they do. The first person is someone called Alyse Parker. I first found her on YouTube quite a few years ago, and she's on Instagram. Yeah, I don't completely connect with everything that she's about, but I just think that as a young woman, she is so inspiring and she's embraced who she is. She's embraced her unique quirks. You can see that in her business, she is doing what aligns with her values and her beliefs. And I believe that that's why she's able to build such a huge audience and become so successful in her business. And she's always been honest when things have shifted and changed for her. So she first started building her platform as a vegan entrepreneur, and she talked a lot about veganism, and then that no longer aligned with who she was, and she made a big announcement that she wasn't vegan anymore, and her business really did take a hit. She had a lot of people unsubscribe and she had a lot of online bullying, and I watched her go through that whole journey. I'm not vegan, by the way. I just liked watching vegan YouTubers. Because she was aligned with who she is and she is standing in her truth, she's been able to just like push past all of that and make something successful of herself. The other INFJ in business that I love watching, his name is Frank James. And Frank James is on YouTube, and I started watching him when he had about 30,000 subscribers. Now he's got something insane, like 700,000 up there. I don't know if this is his actual business. I knew he was an accountant, which I find quite funny for an INFJ. But listen, if you have that many subscribers on YouTube, you're in a business because there's so much involved with YouTube with ad revenue and sponsorships, and there's a lot of money to be made. So he is a businessman in his own right, and I think he's just absolutely smashing it, and he's a great example to look to as well. Whether you believe in the same values as him or not, he's quite funny as well. Like, I think he's freaking hilarious, and he talks a lot about the 16 different personality types and being an INFJ, and he does little skits, and he's just fully embraced his uniqueness, his personality, the way he sees the world, and his quirks. I guess I just want to encourage you that if you've been thinking about starting your own business and becoming an entrepreneur and having an online presence, know that you don't need to be an extrovert. You don't need to be like all these other people. All you need to do is be yourself, love who you are, embrace your quirks, embrace your uniqueness, start working on your self-worth, start working on who you are as a person, and just go for it. Know that it takes time. This has taken me years and years and years and years to get to where I am, but when you believe in what you're doing and you have that grit and determination, then nothing will stop you, and it doesn't matter how long it will take. And for me, I don't care how long it's gonna take. I'm going to keep going because I believe in what I'm doing. I want to encourage you to do the same, because I think INFJs have so much to offer to the world. We have so much to give. We have so much love to give to humanity that it's time that we stop closing ourselves off and stop living in our wounded selves and show the world who we are.